everyone, this is Ira, and I'm back here in my Sky Factory. I'm in my new home, I got my bed here, and I've got a few friends here with me. Welcome, ladies, gentlemen, and everyone in between and outside the borders and everything, welcome to Chickentopia. Topia from the Greek topos, which means place, and chicken from the English chicken, which means chicken. I got some chickens, is what I'm saying. I have been doing some very serious, intensive breeding of chickens for the past few days. And all of the chickens you see here are 10-cubed. 10-cubed. They are 10, 10, 10 chickens. Over here is my breeding station. We're going to take a look at that in a bit. I have not 10-cubed all the chickens. I still have some chickens left to 10-cube. All the ones here are all maxed out. I got some eggs in here. It's a little bit messy here. I actually intended to make this a little bit nicer, but I just kind of been focused on the breeding. I've been very focused on the chickens, like this string chicken right here, for example. Hello, string chicken. You're only an 898. We need to get you to a 10-cubed, friend. Don't worry, we're going to do that. Well, not you personally, but your descendants will be 10-cubed, and there will be much glory and pride and honor in your family. You're going to be a chicken nugget. Sorry. So that's what we're up to. What I've got is a setup for the 10-cube chickens. All of them are in their little nest boxes, and they've got the item conduits from Ender.io hooked up. All of these are hooked up together. The way I'm planning to set up my base, this is the new Diggs base, is I'm going to have these 17 by 17 rooms. It gives me plenty of room to play around. And then in between those 17 by 17 rooms, I have these three tile wide corridors, which are just maintenance corridors where I'll run all the cables and stuff like that. So they're just kind of cobblestone or whatever materials I had on hand when I was building them. So all of these cables run along, all of them are connected, and they go down here. We'll just come down here. I'll show you. So the cables run along here, and they go across the top there. And then they come along and they go up there. And then from here, this is where I had some chickens on this side before. I'll probably take this out, or I may use it for something else. We'll see. And then they come over here. Now, what we got here is a drawer controller. And look at the bounty. Look at the bounty of these chickens, my friends. We've got compacting drawers with all kinds of metals. We've got all these different materials. And this is not even everything yet. We still have some space to expand. As you can see, this room is not done yet. I haven't put all the walls up yet. I don't know if I'm going to have all the walls be these storage drawers or how I'm gonna work it out. I haven't gotten that far yet. But this is what I got so far. Now, this chicken manure drawer, you'll see, it's empty. This one's not empty, but this one is empty. And the reason for that, and also, one other thing, what doesn't go into the drawer controller goes into this small storage crate here. And let's go back downstairs for a moment. Actually, we can just cheat our way down here for now. This isn't all finished yet. So that crate, basically this crate will fill up with eggs. I had, if you noticed, a space for every type of chicken's 10-cubed egg. We'll have a space on this wall. And these are already mostly filled up. They got 8 stacks each. I am not going to expand that. I think 8 stacks of 16 eggs for each type is probably enough. I think it's probably enough. Because that is effectively infinite eggs. Because I can hatch those and grow them into more. So the excess eggs will go into this small storage crate, run along this pipe, which goes into this crate, and then this is the manure, which also goes into this crate here, which is empty at the moment, because we actually are not even producing enough to keep up. And then that goes into this room. This room's got some nice grass floor, and I've got my wooden barrels here, and this is my dirt production system. So that's what I've got going on now. I'm making use of some of the stinkier parts of the chickens. Down here is my power room. We got the power, I showed you the power last time. I am upgrading the power. Well, I'm upgrading the lava generation, which I actually don't need to do yet, because I haven't upgraded the generators yet. But I've got the materials to do it, so why not? I am upgrading, look down here. Oh, that fell in the fire, didn't it? Oh, no, it didn't. There we go. Instead of the netherrack flame, which as you can see at the top of the screen, there gives a 4x rate of melting, I am now using blocks of uranium, which I've got from my delightful little chickens, which give, wait for it, 20 times the rate of melting. So that is very fast melting is what that is. I've also moved my cobblestone generator over here just so I have my infinite cobblestone. The obsidian drawer has been doing very well. It's got over a stack. It actually had a couple of stacks. I actually used some of them already. And I've got all these things here. This, I actually want to turn into glass. This is kind of passive stuff that I've just been leaving down here. I'm not paying that much attention to it. I put a roof up here, actually, of spruce, and I didn't like it. So I'm gonna put a glass roof. It was too dark. I want the sunshine to just shine down here. Oh, I should probably get rid of that, huh? That platform up there. Yeah, probably get rid of that at some point. So, yeah. But there is a problem. There is a problem with this system. Everything is hooked up. Everything is configured properly. But as you can see, when I mouse over, these chicken pens, these nesting pens are full of stuff. And I don't know what's going on here. I have discovered that if I come over here and break one of these pipes, everything is configured properly. I have double and triple and quadruple checked. And then come back here. Now everything's at, now it's all empty. It empties out immediately. But every now and then, it just starts backing up, and I have to, I need to eat some eggs here. Oh, almost out of boiled eggs. I actually discovered the boiled egg is the least nutritious egg that I can make. I should be using the skillet. Oh, now there's a thought. I haven't been saving backup eggs for my food. Oh, hello. Hello there, little aluminum chicken. Gonna be breeding you. How are we doing on eggs? Oh, got an 898 ink black chicken. Need to get the ink black up to 10. Anyway, yeah, I don't have any spare eggs for eating. I'll just grab some out of here for now. But that's a good thought. I should maybe have a little bit more of a buffer than just these backup eggs here, because this is also my food. Close these doors. Close these doors in this wide open environment. There's not a roof or anything. Close the door. You're letting a draft in. Alright, clay, yeah. I can fry those up. Look how much more nutritious those are than the boiled eggs. Prismarine shard, now you're fried. These are ones that I still need to 10 cube. Still need to 10 cube them. I got some lapis here. Whenever I've got some materials in here, I just come over and double right click the storage drawer and it dumps everything in the proper places. I know there's a limit to how far this can go. I haven't reached it yet. All these have been filling in automatically, but we'll see how far I can go before I need to put in a slave. I need a slave. It's time for a slave. Alright, these guys are in the holding area. They are not 10 cubed yet, but I don't have the space to breed them. I'm just doing one at a time. I could probably do a setup where I'm 10 cubing 20 different chickens at once, but I'm just focusing on one at a time because otherwise I'll get distracted and confused. And I know you guys don't want that, do you? Do you? Wait, do you? I hope not. Now, what is this guy here? This guy... Oh, this guy's only a 1-1-1. So he's done then. This is as high as we're gonna get from that guy. We need to put this egg in here. What I should also do... Close your eyes. There we go. What I should also do is put some redstone lamps above this to heat them up, but I found that by leaving the chickens that I'm not using in here, they actually incubate the eggs by standing on them, just by accident. So we're gonna take the string guy who's fully grown and throw him in here. What happens is this silver chicken is a 10 cubed. And so he's kind of bringing this guy up. But I don't think this one can get all the way to 10 cubed unless it has another string chicken next to it of high value. So we'll see how that goes. I might want to hatch two of these guys so that they can go to 10, 10, 10 together. What have we got? Or what do we got here now? I'm losing track of what I'm doing. I'm trying to show you guys my process. Okay, silver is up to 10 cubed. I think I already put silver. Oh no, it was aluminum that I put up here. Aluminum, are you 10 cubed as well? Okay, you are. So aluminum and silver have both hit 10 cubed. I've been taking out one of each of these as I go. I'm out of space for more types of chickens, and I really don't need this many of each type anyway, because I've got more materials than I can use as it is. Maybe I'll take one of the glowstone chickens out, and we'll stick the silver guy in there. Close your eyes. There we go. I need to look into, I've got so much glowstone now, actually. That, oh yeah, I should be getting rid of these. These torches are beautiful, but they don't match everything. I should be taking the glowstone and using blocks of glowstone to light up my place. Oh, I'll work on that soon. I think I can also get the block painter in this pack. I think they have that. Block painter, item buffer, power buffer, painting machine. There we go, painting machine from Ender.io. I think I can throw glowstone in there and paint it to look like whatever I want, which is a very fun and awesome thing, and thank you so much to whoever added that to Minecraft, because that is just spectacular. Look at this, we've got 4 prismarine shard chickens. We don't need this many. We don't need this much quartz. Yeah, some of these guys will be coming out as I 10 cube the rest of these fellas. So aluminum is done. Why are you here? Did I leave your egg in there by accident? Aluminum, we don't need you anymore. I'm gonna leave him in there. You get to live a little bit longer so you can help incubate those eggs. And a matter of fact, I think I'm gonna take these guys over here too. Just to help out with that incubation. And yeah, so at the moment, that's my priority is 10 cubing all of the chickens. Every single one of them. Even the ones I don't really think I'm gonna need very much, I just wanna have them on hand as 10 cubed versions. Just peek in here, 898. No, we need better than 898. You can do better, I know you can. Yes. So something I've discovered is that in these nest boxes, these nesting pens, they seem to be focused on providing more eggs, which makes sense. It's a nest box, it's an egg box. That's what they are for, is for eggs. And so if you put a chicken in here, they'll produce a lot more eggs. However, if you take them out, I think you've noticed, look at this, there's stuff all over the floor. Whenever the chickens are out running free range, they produce a lot more, they produce much fewer eggs, but they produce more of the material that they are set to produce. And that is an important distinction. Because once I get all of my 10 cubed eggs, I'm not gonna need that many eggs for now. I do have plans for the eggs. Oh, don't you worry, guys. I got big plans for all of these eggs that they're producing. It's not just gonna be turned into dirt forever. Actually, I have a thought, which is related to this item right here. Not this extra utilities stupid thing, but this one. The simple generator's culinary generator. Generates power from food, which is based on the food value and the saturation value of the food. And as you can see, we've got a lot of eggs. We've got a lot of eggs coming out of this system. And I feel like with this volume of eggs coming from the nesting pens, and maybe an automatic crafter with the skillet, to turn them into fried eggs, or actually, there was something that was even better. I was looking through the foods. Fried eggs, as you can see, give 2 food and about 4.5 of saturation. On the other hand, if we farm up some bell peppers and some onions, we can make an omelet, and look how good that is. For something that's very simple to make, none of this requires any processing. We can grow some bell peppers, which we can get from a market, we can get seeds for our harvest craft. Which is very easy to craft, we have all we need for that. We can make a farm for bell peppers, a farm for onions. We already have a farm for eggs, it's called Chickentopia. I think you're familiar with it. Then, oh, I lost it. Yeah, we just stick those in an automatic crafter with the skillet, and we have infinite omelets. And I know there are foods that have more saturation and more food value, which we could make, but they all require more processing. And this is a very simple way, which is a primarily chicken-fueled way, to generate power. And I really, like, this is an ambition of mine, is to use this to power my base. We've got the lava power right now, which is working great, and which is indirectly powered by chickens, because I'm slowly converting that all to uranium. And as a matter of fact, I think I could probably do some more of that right now. We must have a whole bunch of uranium blocks. We've got 22 blocks of uranium. Let's grab those babies, let's go downstairs, and let's do a little swapping. Let's upgrade our generation. Boom, boom. Oh, I can't get in here! I've built this all too efficiently now. It's too efficient. It's no longer usable. Its efficiency has made it unusable. There we go, these are all upgraded now. They're gonna be generating lava, like, ridiculously fast. And I have now locked myself in again. And replace these very pretty blocks. They're pretty. That's why they're there. No other reason. They serve no other purpose. If you were thinking, oh, I wonder what the purpose is of those blocks, why she's got them there. No reason. They're just pretty. I like them. And that's it. I don't need another reason. I don't even need another reason. That's reason enough. Look at that. And we are now fully upgraded. Simple as that. Oh, this is exciting. So now, when I get around to it, it's on my list. When I upgrade these generators, I don't even know why I'm doing this. I am almost not using any power at all. What I should do is think of uses for this power, such as the sag mill here, as an example. Like, I can make a whole bunch of sag mills, and I can upgrade them, get them speed upgrades, and I can be pumping out tons of glass and stuff like that. And I'm sure I'll have many other uses for power as I progress. Right now, I'm just so focused on chickens. Ow. There we go. There's my chisel. I wanna put a glass roof on here. I'm not sure what kind of glass I want, though, is the thing. I don't like the totally clear glass, because it looks like there's nothing there, and it kind of defeats the point. Like, I feel like it needs something. Maybe it's quite clear glass. Does this actually... No, see, this is what I'm talking about. I don't want it to be totally clear. I want it to be visible. I don't like the vanilla texture that's on it. It's too much. It's too visible. Got bubble glass. No, I don't know. I'm not sure what I want. Or maybe we could even do... We've got Japanese glass. How would this look? How would this fit in well? Oh, this might fit in well. I realize, by the way, that my base is extremely ugly and that nothing matches. Ooh, we got a dark spot up here. Whoops. Whoopsie daisy. Please forgive me, you guys. This might work, actually. This might look good. Let's do a little bit more of it. And, let's just see how it looks when we get a significant area filled in. Let's just use that all up. When we come down here. That's not too bad. I don't know, I don't love it. But it looks okay. I feel like... I don't know, I'm gonna keep thinking about it. If anyone has any suggestions for, better glass for the roof, let me know. Please do, leave a comment, let me know. I am not great at the building, as you can see. I'm learning. I'm getting better. Like, I really feel like the dark wood and the cobblestone go really well together. Also, I think the spruce and the dark oak, like, I feel like the color scheme in here is pretty good. But the design, the overall design is not. This, by the way, this is chisel and bits into slabs, because you can't make slabs out of chiseled blocks. But you can just chisel half of it away. So that works. I'm gonna leave this for now. I'm gonna keep thinking about it. It's not essential, it's just a decorative thing. And I'm very focused on, as you know, I'm very focused on these. See, now we've still... I think this may be the best we can get. But is that what I already have? 898. Are you 898? You are. So maybe we just need another 898 to partner that up with. Maybe we're at the point where we need the same type of chicken now. So I'm gonna take these guys out. This is my process. As you can see, I think it's getting a little crowded over there. We'll stick him over there. Oh, got you in the fence. I apologize for that. We've got the ink black guys in here, and now these ones are the same type, and so we'll get... It should be possible. These are 898s. It should be possible to get 10-10-10s out of here. So I'm going to take all of this, stick the string, we'll throw these ones in the compost. So this is pretty much what I've been doing. I've been spending hours and hours just doing this. And I know I could be more efficient about it. I'm very well aware of that. But this is what I'm doing so far. Oh! Glowstone is coming down here. Does that mean the glowstone is full? It is. Ooh, there's something I have not planned for, because I'm a fool. So this is something I need to figure out then. I need to figure out how to whitelist only the eggs coming out. Problem is, there's a lot of different eggs. My question is, obviously all the eggs can be treated as, I actually have an item filter here. All the eggs can be treated as eggs for the purposes of crafting and stuff, so that makes me think that match metadata? If I turn ignore metadata, I think that means any egg will go through. Let's see if that works. So this now says only let... Technically it says only let 888 lead chicken eggs go through. Let's see if it lets other items through. Because I honestly do... I'm not... No. No, that's not going to work. There's too many different types of eggs. The other option is to blacklist. I can blacklist all the... No, that's also way too many items. This is something I'm not sure how to solve. I'm going to have to think about this. This is not so simple. Is there... Okay, so question for all of you viewers. This is important stuff here. Is there a way to use just an item filter? Keep twisting my ankle there. Just an item filter to allow only eggs through. But all types of eggs. Anything that fits the egg item type. Because this is obviously not good enough. Is there something else I can do? Is there another type of item filter? Oh boy. Item, not fe. There we go. Advanced item filter. Existing item filter. Selects only items already in the inventory. Selects only items for specified mods. That could work. Because I can let all of the hatchery stuff go through. That's actually fine. Oh, yeah, that works. How do I make that? With a Yetta wrench. And I am pretty sure I've got extra Yetta wrenches back here at the spawn base. Pretty sure. Probably have a whole pile of them from loot bags and stuff. I do. All right, let's try this. Let's see how this works, because this could work. This could work. Paper. This is my very simple sugarcane farm. There's these growth crystals. Obviously, all of this stuff, everything is going to be moved. Things are slowly but surely being moved. You can see I've cleared out a lot of this, not all of it yet, but things are happening. Things are happening. Let's go back. Let's go to crafting table here. Let's make a whole bunch of paper. And let's make a mod item filter. I'm learning as I go here, friends. This is an interesting experience. So this would let all the hatchery items through. It's just... Yeah, it seems... Nothing else is going to come through from there other than manure. And if the manure... This is on a lower priority than this, so that should go there. And the manure is going to the same place anyway, so that would actually be fine. So let's take this baby out and stick this baby in. How does this work? Hatchery. Oh. Hatchery. Whitelist. Is that going to work? Is it working? Are you doing the thing? It's empty. Glowstone stays. Nighttime. Why is it always nighttime? Why does time go by so quickly? All these are starting to back up again. So let's go. Okay, if anyone has any idea why this is happening, please do let me know. There is an inventory for these things to go to. Everything is hooked up and configured properly, and it just randomly stops working. And I don't get it, and I don't like it. That's part of frustrating. So let's go down. Let's check in here. Is anything coming through? I think everything's probably going through too quickly. Is anything hanging out in this crate? So the eggs are not coming out. The eggs are not coming out of here. Extract. Always active. Whitelist hatchery. Alright, I really don't know. I feel like that should work. These all say hatchery. Alright, I'm stumped. I'm gonna do some research. But if any of you guys has any idea how to make this happen, how to make this work, I would appreciate it. If anyone has any idea what's causing my system to get all clogged up, please let me know. I get a little tired of constantly having to fix the pipes. For now, I'm probably just gonna keep focusing on getting my chickens bred up to 10 cubed level. We're so close with the inky black chickens. And, yeah, next time I check in with you guys, I hope to have this area a lot more organized. I will probably have the chickens whose materials I'm more interested in getting running around free range with just some item collectors and chests to collect their drops so we get more of their actual materials and fewer eggs. And that's the current deal. That's the current project. I've got a lot of other ideas. There's some farming I need to do. I need to start Botania. Of course, I need to upgrade my jetpack. My jetpack is garbage. And Actually, there was one really cool thing that I realized I can do, which is instead of using Journey Map to teleport, I can use travel anchors from Ender.io, which is basically like teleporting. It's instant teleportation, but it's not technically cheating the way what I've been doing now is technically cheating. But the issue with Ender.io travel anchors is they only go about 50 blocks in each direction, so I would have to make little hoppy islands from place to place, and that's a project I kind of want to do. I think that sounds like fun. Eventually, I hope to get all this stuff moved over here anyway. But this is my spawn base, you know? I don't want to abandon it completely. I still go back for nostalgic purposes every now and then. I think it's a pretty reasonable thing to do, don't you? And what else have I got on my list here? Magical crops. I know magical crops are a thing. I know they're probably more efficient than the chickens. I am determined to use the chickens for as much as possible. However, there are a few things chickens can't do, like making the special armors. So I am going to work towards that. That's on my list. And I need to get some more building materials. There's some types of saplings that I've seen on other streams. What is it? Fuse wood? I know you can get these. I don't know how you can get them. Is it by... soul sand through a mesh. Sieving. This is something that has to be sieved. I cannot get this from chickens. Why can't I get these from chickens? This is ridiculous. So I will probably try to do that to get more building materials. And yeah, those are my plans for the time being. That's my goals for the moment. So let's stand here in front of Chickentopia. I think we're about out of time for this episode. I want to thank you guys for joining me. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have questions, comments, suggestions, ideas, and if for God's sake, if any of you have any idea how to fix the Ender.io stuff, which is getting all goofed up, please do leave a comment. I will be so, so happy to hear from you. I will send you a virtual hug if no real life in person hugs are available. I'll just send you a virtual one. You guys understand the intent. It's good. If you like this video, please do leave a like. If you didn't like it, you can leave a thumbs down. And I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye, everybody.